this is such a wonderful tradition that we share of celebration, reflection, and also, of course, inspiration. I'm always personally challenged by this ceremony to strive for more. More fairness, more awareness, more action, and more results. I've been told by many as they watch the tape versions over the years on HTV that we provide a history lesson which in turn challenges those even beyond this room today. I look around and I see many of you who are actively sowing into others, lifting them up, believing that together we can create an even greater tomorrow. That's what the women in our Hall of Fame have done, you see. They've held tight to the hope of what the tomorrow they create can hold and not let go, even facing the most difficult of situations. I ask you, with us today, to hold very tightly to hope and never let go. That is, until it's time to hand a portion to someone else. Our responsibility is to guard it and pass it along. Again, these women have done what it takes to leave that legacy that we can look to for our inspiration. Today we come together wearing a lot of titles, a lot of badges, a lot of different labels. What the Hillsborough Commission on the Status of Women asks you to do is to come alongside of us to find our common ground. There are issues of importance that we know need all of our attention, our creativity, our sacrifice, and most importantly, our partnerships. We recently joined together with many government, business, and civic leaders to raise awareness about pay equity. We evidenced again the power of a community to declare what is acceptable, what is our standard, and not look back. I'm very grateful to stand before you again today. This will be my last time presiding over this ceremony in the capacity of chair of our county's Commission on the Status of Women. I've enjoyed so much the opportunity to be of service in this way to the women, and ultimately, I believe, all of the citizens of our community. I want to thank Commissioner Al Higginbotham for seeing my ability to impact, even when I didn't. I want to thank those legacy members on the commission who welcomed me and nurtured me. I thank all those on the commission over my tenure who have worked so hard to shine a light and create change on issues of such pressing importance. I'm also deeply appreciative of the members of our county commission and other government officials who consistently not only support our work, but participate in it. I'm humbled by the network of men and women who have given us support and opportunities to be catalysts for change. Our partnerships are deeply grounded and our platform is expanded because of each of you. It is truly amazing what we can accomplish together. Who's ever heard me say that? I want to remind each of you of your value in this equation. We are each important in what we bring, and when you realize your value, you activate your power. Seize the power that is uniquely yours and the ability you have to make an impact. Again, thank you for being with us today. We're here to celebrate lives of impact. Join me in wanting more as a result of learning about the journeys, the struggles, and the great accomplishments of these ladies today. At this time, I'd like you to please stand as Commissioner Ashley Carl leads us in the Pledge of Allegiance, and please remain standing as Commissioner Kevin Beckner offers our invocation.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Yvonne, thank you so much for your leadership. We really recognize what you have done in your leadership role for on the Commission of Status of Women. So I first want to recognize and thank you for all that you have done over your tenure. And we are certainly going to miss you not being in charge, but we know that you're going to continue to lead the effort and the work that you all do. So thank you so very much. I would like to extend a warm welcome to our fellow elected officials that are here today and members of the clergy, the Commission on the Status of Women, members, community leaders, guests, and to all and past present Women's Hall of Fame inductees. Let us bow our heads and to pray. Today we come together through the ordination of God, who is known by many names through many faiths. Thank you for the opportunities you have afforded each of us to serve our neighbors, the citizens of Hillsborough County. Heavenly Father and Blessed Mother, we thank you for the meals that have been placed before us. Please lead them to the nourishment of our bodies and our bodies to your service. Thank you for all the men and women here and the plans you have made for their individual lives. I ask that the occasion be one of joy and reflection on the selfless work and courage exhibited by the three amazing women we are celebrating today. May they be blessed abundantly for their good works. We ask these things in your many names. Amen.
Thank you, Ashley and Commissioner Beckner. Please be seated and help me welcome County Commissioner and Chair of the County Commission, Sandy Merman.
Thank you, Yvonne, and good afternoon, everyone. This is such a great audience we have here today. I'm looking out here and seeing so many friends, and Betty Kasser, Judy Genshaft, Mercy DeMaio is back there. How are you? Just so many people that have been so contributed so much to our community over the years. But we're pleased to be here. We're going to celebrate our 2015 inductees into the Hillsborough County Women's Hall of Fame. Dr. Sylvia Marion Carley, Matilda Martinez Garcia, and the late Josephine Howard Stafford for their amazing legacy of transformational leadership and their civic contributions to Hillsborough County. We're also here to acknowledge and commend all past inductees into the Hall of Fame for their significant and sustained achievements. But I'd like to just take this moment to commend our sponsoring organization and its chair of today's programs, the Hillsborough County Commission on Status of Women. And I would like to just give Yvonne Fry a round of applause for her contributions and everything she's done for this commission to elevate it to really great things in our community. She has certainly been our women's cheerleader, so to speak, and really, I think, move the dial on how women are getting involved in our community. As Yvonne mentioned earlier, I am chair of the Hillsborough County Commission. I, of course, am the only female currently serving on the County Commission, but I do love that. I do have that opportunity to work with my fellow male counterparts in a very productive way. So it's very exciting. But I think what I want to really mention is women are making terrific strides in business and in leadership, helping to change the world for the better. And we all know the statistics don't totally reflect how great those changes are. Women are still only about 3 to 5% of CEOs, yet we're seeing a tremendous surge in women-owned businesses here in the state of Florida. In fact, we are in the top 5 in the country in women-owned businesses, and that is a significant accomplishment. But I do think why there are so many more women-owned businesses is because they're not getting to the place they want to be in the boardroom. And so they're deciding to open up their own business, create their own opportunity. And I think, you know, what it points out is that we have a long way to go before we get to true parity with our esteemed male colleagues. We have a journey to go before we achieve equity in the corporate boardrooms, in our councils, commissions, legislatures, and Congress. And pay and professional advancement, all of us have to play a role in having this parity. I have been in the legislature. Kathy Castor is in Congress. We know women have never really been more than 25% of the elected bodies. And yet we're 53% of the voters in our state. We have a long way to go to achieve parity. And I think it's just by working together. All of you know I'm working on several initiatives, a women's conference next year, where we have launched, and I helped found the Women's Exchange to help give women more access to committees and appointments and leadership positions, create more advocacy for women, sometimes where we're on worst enemy, and really be mentors and advisors to many other women that we see have potential and move them forward. But we know a great deal of work still has to be done. And I'm just very fortunate in Hillsborough County to have the Commission on Status of Women leading the charge to really support our women and get so much done in the terms of parity and empowerment and success of women in our community. And of course, under the leadership of Chair Yvonne Frye, she is now serving, if y'all didn't know, her second term as chair of the Florida Commission on Status of Women. That is a significant accomplishment for Yvonne, and I really, again, give her a round of applause because that's a big deal. And she is working on convening women statewide to help move us ahead and really get women in the proper place where we all need to be. The Commission on Status of Women has done so many numerous things. Pay equity is an issue, sex, domestic abuse, sex trafficking of minors, three major issues that they have been charged of, that they have really moved forward. And of course, all these initiatives have roots in our county, Hillsborough County, that's really helping to make the difference. And throughout today's awards ceremony, you're going to learn about the tremendous transformational legacy of female leadership in our county. But if you look at the word legacy and what it means sustaining, long-lasting. So women, we've got to get together and create a larger legacy for women in our community. I think it's very important that we set our goals on that and really focus on it. And so today, as we celebrate the fact that the Hillsborough County Commission on Status of Women is truly living the legacy, because that's our theme, provided to us by past and current members of the Hillsborough County Women's Hall of Fame through their dedication, leadership, and service to our community. They are truly leading the charge, and I want to thank you all for being here today. Congratulations to all of the 2015 Hall of Fame inductees, and it is my honor to be here among you today. Thank you all so much.
Thank you, Chairwoman Merman. We're grateful for your words. We appreciate the strong support and open communication we have with all members of our County Commission, which really allows us to work successfully on issues affecting the women in our county. At this time, I'm very pleased to welcome Vice Chair of the Commission, India Whitty, to share the purpose of the Commission on the Status of Women, as well as to offer some other updates on our work. India?
Thank you. Thank you very much, Yvonne. As Yvonne shared, my name is India Whitty, and I am honored and thrilled to be the University of South Florida representative on the Hillsborough County Commission on the Status of Women, and serve with really amazing transformational leaders in this body to help affect change in our communities. It's my privilege to stand here today representing our fellow commissioners and share with each of you a little bit of a history on the Hillsborough County Commission on the Status of Women. The commission was created on April 16, 2003, to advise the Board of County Commissioners, the county administration, the community, and all agencies and persons in Hillsborough County with respect to matters pertaining to the status of women in our communities. The Commission on the Status of Women is comprised of 15 amazing, talented, committed women leaders. Seven are appointed by their respective county commissioners, and eight, such as myself, represent organizations that hold a permanent seat on the commission. Each year, we thoughtfully examine the state of women in our communities, and we choose a topic that we hope will ignite our community to take action. In the past, the commission has focused on a number of topical issues impacting women and families. They include the plight of homeless female veterans, health and healthcare access for women and children, sex trafficking of minors, domestic violence, and the financial freedom for women to include championing equal pay for equal work. And the reason that we are all gathered here today and a task that's near and dear to each of our hearts is the establishment and maintenance of the Hillsborough County Women's Hall of Fame. In 2012, at the request of the Board of County Commissioners, our body accepted a new and very exciting responsibility. The commission performs an annual review of nominations and select 6 amazing young people to receive the Youth Excellent and Achievement Awards. The Yay Awards honorees are nominated from throughout Hillsborough County schools in middle and high school. And they are evaluated, and it's a very, very difficult evaluation process. We just came off of it in the last several weeks, and it was like Solomon's choice. But you all should be very gratified at the state of our young people in our community, because there are tremendous young people that are doing amazing things despite very difficult odds. But we evaluated their scholastic efforts, volunteer activities, and community service. And we're pleased on Wednesday, many of us on the commission, to join the Hillsborough County Commission in honoring the 6 Yay Middle School Award winners. It is on county TV, I believe, so I invite each of you to go out and watch the presentations to these amazing young people. They're truly inspirational. Another strong transformational activity that we've taken up in the last several years is convening a fall issues forum. And this year we decided that we needed to expand our scope and reach of understanding. So we developed and established a fall issues forum advisory council to advise and assist us in developing the 2015 fall issues forum. Our focus this year will be on women's health, and we look forward to working with Laura Hobner with Tampa General Hospital, Carrie Hepburn with Tampa Bay Healthcare Collaborative, Pamela Malone Quarles with St. Joseph Women's Hospital, and she's here with us today, wherever you are, Pamela. Dr. Donna Peterson from USF's College of Public Health, and Dr. Valerie Whiteman from USF's College of Medicine. And we'll be working very closely with them to develop our strategy for action in addressing important concerns affecting women's health in our community. We're particularly appreciative of the generosity of those individuals and organizations that are sponsoring today's events. Your financial support has allowed the commission to focus on the many issues confronting the women of our community. And in addition, you have afforded us the opportunity to recognize and honor 3 amazing Hillsborough County women of distinction through their induction in the Women's Hall of Fame. On their behalf and on behalf of all my fellow commissioners, we thank you.
Thank you, India. I'm so grateful for your leadership in our community and your tremendous contribution to our commission. I would like to now welcome Commissioner Stacey Frank to introduce the other members of the Commission on the Status of Women.
How are you all doing? I'm very pleased this afternoon to introduce the members of the commission. And I also want to introduce the commissioners who appointed the members and the representatives of the organizations who appointed the members as well. So when I mention your names, please stand, and at the end of the presentation, we'll give you a round of applause. First commission member is Denise Chavez. She was appointed by Commissioner Merman, District 1. Y'all are supposed to stand. Where are you? The next is, Commission Member Connie Gage, appointed by Victor Chris, Commissioner of District 2. Unfortunately, Commissioner Chris could not make it today. He had a prior commitment. Our next member of the commission is Ann Porter, who was appointed by Commissioner Les Miller of District 3. Again, unfortunately, Commissioner Miller had a prior commitment. Susan Leisner was appointed by Stacy White, Commissioner of District 4. Dottie Grover Skipper was appointed by Ken Hagen, Commissioner District 5. Stacy Frank was appointed by Kevin Beckner, Commissioner District 6. Our Commission Chair Yvonne Fry was appointed by Al Higginbotham, Commissioner District 7. Unfortunately, he had a prior commitment as well. It was previously noted that Yvonne also has the honor of serving on the Florida Commission of the Status of Women and serves as the chair of that organization as well. We have today, among the commission members who are appointed by organizations, we have Ashley Carl, who is appointed by Dr. Kenneth Atwater, who is president of HCC, and unfortunately he was unable to attend, but he sends his congratulations to the inductees. Representing the League of Women Voters of Hillsborough County is Linda De Aquila, who is joined by Shirley Acuri, president of the League. Representing the Greater Tampa Chamber of Commerce is Kim DeBosier, who is joined by Karen Arnold, senior vice president for investor relations for the chamber. The commission representative for the Center for Women is Catherine Pravlik, who is joined by Alice Thompson, director of employment for the Center for Women and a former member of the commission. The National Council of Negro Women is represented by Commission Member Geraldine Twine, who could not join us today because she has the good fortune of being at her grandson's graduation from law school. But in her absence, we are pleased and honored to recognize Lucille Morris, past president of the National Council of Negro Women. And we also have as Commission Member Jennifer Willahan, honorary chair of the Hispanic Professional Women's Association, who is joined by Maria Van Galder, who is president of the Hispanic Professional Women's Association. As you noticed, as India spoke earlier, she is a representative on the commission from USF, and we have with us today Dr. Ginshaft, the president of University of South Florida. We have, lastly but not least, representing the Spring of Tampa Bay, its CEO and president, Mindy Murphy. So please join me in giving a round of applause to our members and our appointee. Thank you.
Thank you, Stacy. I'm honored to serve alongside of each of these women. I'm also proud to welcome two other members of the Florida Commission on the Status of Women with us today. Janine Hawkins McKinnon and Debbie Cox Roush are over here in the front. Would y'all stand and be recognized as well? I'd like to take a moment and recognize those women already inducted into the Hillsborough County Women's Hall of Fame. There is a listing in your program, but those that are with us today that have been inducted in previous years, would you please stand and be recognized as well? Give them a round of applause. Thank you. Each of these women have inspired generations of Hillsborough County women. I'm personally so thankful for each of you and the trails you've blazed that benefit us all. One more round of applause. Those are some pretty amazing women. Yes. In addition to our county commissioners who've been recognized, I also want to recognize our other elected officials who've joined us today. Would you be so kind to stand and let us give you a round of applause as well? Thank you all for being here and all of your work and service. It's now my pleasure to welcome Congresswoman Kathy Castor to offer a brief overview of the national bipartisan movement to highlight and resolve issues that impact women and families.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. I'm so honored to be here. Thank you, Yvonne, and thank you, Yvonne, for your years of service to Hillsborough County and the Commission of the Status of Women. You've done a wonderful job, and to all of the commissioners who devote their time to making our community a better place, thank you. And to Chairwoman Sandy Merman, it's good to see that we have a strong female there in the commissioner's the chair seat. And it was nice to see my high school friend, Ken Hagen. He doesn't mind moving aside at all if you're going to be chair. So, but I'm really honored to be here today with the three women who are being honored, because they're remarkable, each and every one of them. Dr. Sylvia Marion Carley is one of Hillsborough County's most committed educators. And that's saying something in this community. She is never satisfied unless young African American and Latino students understand the opportunities they have to be successful. I've watched what you've done over the past decades, what you have done in establishing The brown college-bound program is now a national model, and that she brings together educators from all across the country to be sure that they are doing the best they can in getting students to community college and to universities. So congratulations, Dr. Carley. And to the family of Josephine Howard Stafford, it's great to celebrate the trailblazing female attorney of one of the leaders of Tampa. She loved the city of Tampa so much and was a great inspiration. And then to Matilda Martinez Garcia. Matilda, you are an icon. You are an icon of women's leadership. Matilda worked for 43 years for the Social Security Administration. She came up through the ranks and was eventually the Hispanic Program Officer for the 19 Social Security offices all across Central Florida. But more than that, she's had the ear of political leaders for decades. She has been an ever-present moral force, and I've come to love her dearly. And you know, these honorees reflect a wonderful tradition that we have here in Hillsborough County. Strong female leadership. Hillsborough County is known across the country for the tradition that we have here, especially in public service and political leadership. There was something about the convergence of the women's rights movement in the late 1960s, early 70s, and a growing, dynamic, diverse community here in Hillsborough County. I know, because I'm a product of that tradition. I was born into this crucible of female leadership concentrated in the awakening of the 1970s. See, my mother, Betty Castor, who began her career as a teacher, would take me, in addition to dance classes where I did not excel, she would take me to meetings of the League of Women Voters or Save Our Bay, and yes, Sandy, to Hillsborough County Commission meetings. I had a front row seat to the early equal rights battles and outspoken women like Cecile Esrig and Pat Frank and Helen Gordon Davis and Sandy Freeman and Arthenia Joyner and Mary Figg and Jan Platt and so many others. So 2 days before Mother's Day, and Mom, 3 days before your birthday, thank you. Thank you. Thanks to all of these terrific and brave women. And look around this room today and reflect upon the female leaders in this community. Mother's Day means something extra special here in Hillsborough County. It's a time to reflect and salute these honorees and the trailblazers who charted the leadership path years before. And now, a generation later, we should take note of their legacy. And this is kind of fun, and I'll bring it to a close. A couple of years ago, if you were paying attention, and you took a little survey of leadership positions, women at one time held a majority on the Hillsborough County Board of County Commissioners, on the Hillsborough County School Board, the mayor's office, we had female mayors, the school superintendent was female. The county administrator was female. The editor of the Tampa Tribune was female. The president of the multi-campus and dynamic University of South Florida was female. The chief of police was female. And even the commander of MacDill Air Force Base. So that's pretty. Tell me a community across America that can match what has been going on here in Hillsborough County. And speaking of the chief of police, thank you, Jane Castor, for your years of service to your hometown with style and grace and a sense of humor. But I'd like to close by saying, do not take this progress for granted. It really should inspire each one of you to do more for women in our community that still need equal pay. We need more women in the business world. Where are the next Liz Smiths, Mindy Grossman's, Sarah Blakely's in the business world? We need more women in Congress. Congress is still under 20%. And for goodness sake, let's hope the governor's mansion and the White House are not far off. But we also need your focus right here in Hillsborough County, where a recent report said that the odds of escaping poverty are worse in Hillsborough County for poor children than in other communities around the country. And we cannot let this stand. So thank you, Commission on the Status of Women, as listing this as your top priority. Let's commit to helping them meet their important mission. And happy Mother's Day to everyone. Thank you.
Thank you, Congresswoman Castor. It's always a pleasure to have you back in Tampa, but we really appreciate what you're doing for us in Washington, D.C. I'd like to ask Representative Dan Rollerson to also offer a few remarks on behalf of our legislative delegation. Dan?
Thank you, Yvonne, and good afternoon. How y'all doing? Yvonne, I first want to say congratulations to your leadership, a Plant City girl. You have made Plant City very proud, and we appreciate that very much. Now, from a legislative perspective, in 1992, Governor Lawton Childs proposed and the legislature passed a bill that created a permanent Florida Women's Hall of Fame. If you've ever been to the Capitol and you walk in the plaza, you'll see the plaques along the wall. It's an awesome display, and to walk around and look at what the different walks of life where these women came from and what they achieved and what their positions were is fascinating. It is, and it states that it is the intent of the legislature to recognize and honor these women who, through their works and lives, have made significant improvement of life for women and for all citizens in Florida. Now, I must say that the list of women that have stepped up to the plate to lead in Hillsborough County has been very impressive. Mayor Sandy Friedman, Dottie Berger McKinnon, Sandy Merman, Betty Reed, Betty Castor and Kathy Castor, the dynamic duo, and the legend herself, and the one that I am very privileged to continue to serve with today, is Senator Arthenia Joyner. I've learned some things from Arthenia. You know, you just don't mess around with Arthenia. She knows her stuff, and if you sit down and you debate with her, you better know your stuff or you're gonna look pretty silly. She is a champion, and she is a great inspiration. When I moved to Plant City, we had a woman mayor. Many of you know, Sadie Martin. And she was a mayor for several terms, which in Plant City is tough to do. But you, again, you have to know your stuff. She was a great leader. She was a great seller of the city of Plant City. In fact, she was a lot of the reason that the Reds, the Cincinnati Reds, came to Plant City to train for several years. Now, we have made history in the legislature this year, in some ways. Okay, you got it. It took a while, but you got it. Okay. But one of the ways that we made history that I am very proud of is that as the chair of the Joint Legislative Audit Committee, I was privileged to appoint, with the House and the Senate confirmation, the first female Auditor General for the state of Florida, Cheryl Norman. Let's give her a round of applause, folks. And that is a huge responsibility because the Auditor General is charged with examining and making sure that our state government and other governments, including, as all of you know, the county school boards, operate effectively and efficiently. She went through a vigorous process, but she was deemed to be the most qualified, and we are very proud of that fact. Now, women are paving the way not only for women, but for men. Let's face it, leadership is leadership, no matter how you slice it. So, in closing, my philosophy has always been, be nice to women, because you never know when they're gonna be your boss. God bless you, have a great day.
Thank you. The legislative delegation's recognition and support of our efforts is greatly appreciated, Dan, and thank you for being here with us. Now, without further ado, let us begin our ceremony with our first inductee, Dr. Sylvia Marion Carley. And to introduce her, please welcome her daughter, Ivana Chardet Sylvia Carley. Ivana is a graduate of Hillsborough County Schools and a graduate of Florida Agricultural and Mechanical University with a degree in political science. Ivana currently serves as a financial associate at Suncoast Schools Credit Union,
Most importantly of all, she is the daughter, she is the mother of Simone, the youngest grandchild of our recipient.
Good afternoon. It's been said that a mother's heart is the child's classroom. And I thank God for all that my mother, Dr. Sylvia Marion Carley, has taught me. She's taught me the importance of a relationship with God. She has taught me to endure all things. Finally, she has taught me a constant devotion to family and community. I attribute many of my successes to her encouragement and her belief in me. In her, I see many things: wife, mother, sister, niece, cousin, Mimi, confidant, scholar, and humanitarian. While I may be nearing the end of this page, I am not even close to the end of my list of thank yous. For my daughter and I, Dr. Sylvia Marion Carley, you are the true MVP. Go ahead and say it.
Yeah.
Okay, come up, Mimi.
Come up, Mimi.
Whatever the mind can conceive, and you truly believe, you can achieve. Thank you to my daughter and Simone for that touching and heartfelt introduction. To the Hillsborough County Commissioners, to the members of the Hillsborough County Commission on the Status of Women, I stand before you today because someone else had faith in me long enough and far enough, far out to gain that faith, even for me to find that confidence in me. You thought me worthy, and I am and will forever be eternally grateful. To my families, I thank you for this honor, and I thank you for standing with me, especially during my developmental years, and when I took you to the edge of your comfort zone. Well, I was just getting new learning. To my family, who thought me worthy enough to nominate me for this acknowledgement, Dr. Sharon Miller, Dr. Kenneth Atwater, Dr. Lawrence Morehouse, Dr. Adrian Garcia, and Judge Barbara Twine Thomas. Thank you for advocating my selection to the Hillsborough County Women's Hall of Fame. To my biological family, especially those who are no longer here, paved the way for me to think of others. I call the name of my father, Erman Marion, my mother, Atheline Marion, my grandparents, John Clark, and especially my grands, Gussie Sylvia Watson, who encouraged me to make a difference. She would consistently say to me, "People should know that you've been there." Sometimes she was talking about the yard. And I cannot go another moment without my missing my sister, Irma Lee Marion. She provided life to any situation. I am fortunate to have my family voices to guide me and remind me of my grant's charge. My family is here today. Please stand. You have stood with me all these years. Auntie Florence, my mother's sister, I hear you loud and clear, and I depend on you to keep me sane and not forgetting that I must never forget where I came from. And I thank you consistently for reminding me that only the things that you do for Christ will last. My husband, who stood with me during my mother's greatest challenges, my brother, who I dearly love and serves as my sounding board in the vetting of my new ideas. Thank you to my cousins, and I especially thank my granddaughter, Simone, who this week declared Mimi is a princess. Thank you. Extended family is like the foundation of a house. Without the foundation, there is no house. To my HCC family, please stand. Thank you for over 40 years of allowing me to serve you and serve with you, allowing me the opportunity to work on my passion of making a difference in the lives of students. I am truly honored that you have taken time out of your day to come and share this event with me. Thank you much. To my church family, Beulah Baptist Institutional Church, please stand. Led by Dr. W. James Ferret, who prays for me and with me. You help me to keep my spirit of hope and faith alive for you and within me. I thank you much. My mentors who are no longer here, I continue to hear them and feel their spirit each time I take a step. Molly Boone, Sybil Barnes, Mogul Dupree, and Gwendolyn Stevenson. These individuals shared their love, their knowledge, and their wisdom with me. God bless me with additional opportunities to serve. I value my work and ask the board members and family members of the Florida Education Board to please stand. The Florida Education Board provides students with the very thing that is needed to sustain the growth of future professionals for the academy. Money. Please give. We want them to continue to find a way to work at all levels to inspire and uplift students. Last year, I attended my 50th class reunion for Middleton Senior High School. Many of us were absent. I thought I still have opportunities for people to feel my having been there. And now to my sisters. Please stand as I call your name. You know, the sisters who work with a passion in making a difference for the lives of young people, day in and day out. They're working in this community, the Athena Society. Please stand. You can see them working with young people, especially the young women of promise. The National Sorority of Phi Delta Kappa, the Xenos. I tell you, is a group that they work with. And I was a Xeno 50 years ago. The National Council of Negro Women, please stand. They work with Destiny's Promise. And as you know, the National Council of Negro Women was founded by none other than Dr. Mary McLeod Bethune. Of course, I graduated from Bethune-Cookman University. And to the illustrious women of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Incorporated, please stand. These individuals consistently serve throughout the community through such groups as the Precious Pearls, the Emerging Young Leaders, and the Ascend Sisters. Let us increase our press. We need even stronger women to strengthen our nation. I thank you. It has been an honor to share these few moments with you. I am grateful that we must not forget where we come from. People need to feel in a positive way that we've been there and that we are responsible for cutting the path for those who come behind us. I thank you so much for this honor.
Thank you, Ivana and Simone, and congratulations, Dr. Carley. I want Simone to declare me a princess this week. We'll move now to our next honoree, Matilda Martinez Garcia. Please welcome Matilda's nephew, Glenn Gulo. Glenn shared with us that Matilda is one of 9 siblings. His mother, who passed away a few years ago, was one of her sisters. His mother and Matilda were very close, and Matilda and her husband, Max, are his godparents. Matilda's son, Max, and Glenn are about the same age and are friends, as well as cousins. Glenn spent a lot of time with Matilda and her family when he was growing up, spent the night at her home, went on joint vacations, celebrated all holidays, attended Sunday Mass, but most of all, he wanted everyone to know how much he respects and loves her. Glenn.
Thank you. Bienvenidos. Welcome, everybody. If you don't mind, I'm going to start with a short story, a story my mother told me when I was growing up. It's a little bit inspirational, and like most stories, it begins like this. Once upon a time, there was a young, curious girl who had an older brother. One day, she saw her older brother pick up a book, climb a tree to read. She thought that was a good idea. Said if a boy could do that, so can a girl. So she tucked the book under her arm, found a suitable tree, reached up into the branches, and started to climb. She found a nice, comfortable spot and settled in. And even though it was a struggle to get there, a lot of work and a little risky, she felt gratified because from that point of view, she could see things a little clearer. She could see a perspective of the neighborhood that she hadn't noticed. She also intuitively realized that from her new position, she could reach out and give others a hand up. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Glenn Gulo, and I've been asked to say a few words today about Matilda Martinez Garcia. Those in the family, we just call her Mati, and I call her my aunt, my godmother, and my inspiration. And in a way, I'm a little unusual to give her this introduction today, because you see, I've never served on a committee with her or on a board. I didn't work with her at the Social Security Administration. And although I know a lot of what she's accomplished, I don't know everything. And I was trying to figure out, how can I summarize in a few words all of her accomplishments? So a couple of weeks ago, I had lunch with Matilda, and we chatted about many things. She told me stories of her youth and her childhood. And after lunch, she said, well, go back up to the apartment, because I have a file there I call my bio. Right? So we went up to her apartment, and she looked through the apartment and couldn't find it. She looked through her desk and couldn't find it. She thumbed through her file cabinet, but couldn't find it. And then just casually, off the cuff, she said, I don't know why I can't find it. It's a thick file. Ladies and gentlemen, she had just done what I couldn't do. She had summarized all her years of community service, a thick file that she had built over almost 90 years. Now, many of you know that Matilda fights behind the scenes for political and social justice, right? Did you know that early on she ran for public office? Yes. You see, Matilda's from a large family, about the size of a small country. She is. She grew up in a home in West Tampa with her grandmother, her parents, and her eight brothers and sisters. If you count those up on your fingers, you run out of fingers, because there's 12 people. 12 people sharing a home and one bathroom. You wonder why she's so disciplined? Well, the nine brothers and sisters were a large enough group, she said, to form a club. So they formed a club, and all clubs need leadership. Her oldest brother, Andrew, wanted to be president. Those of you who know Matilda won't be surprised when I tell you she also wanted to be president. They had an election. Maybe she should have formed a political action committee, because it didn't turn out so well. See, her brother and her split the votes, and a younger sister was elected. True? Right. But that didn't stop her. Her public service had just begun, and she has accomplished so many things since then, really too many to memorize. So I've typed them all out, and for the next 2 hours, I'm going to read a list of everything that she's accomplished. All right, it won't be 2 hours, but it'll just be a second, just a small sampling. She served in organizations such as the Tampa Hispanic Heritage Board, the Mayor's Hispanic Advisory Council, the Florida Institute of Community Studies, the State of Florida Governor's Commission on Hispanic Affairs. She was a state director of the League of United Latin American Citizens, or LULAC, for many years, where the local chapter named an award after her, the Mati Award. It's a scholarship. She was the chair of the Tampa Bay Federal Equal Employment Opportunity Committee, where they named an award after her, the Matilda Garcia Total Commitment Award. And speaking of awards, she's a proud recipient of many, including Tampa Bay Silver Medallion Humanitarian Award, the Lifetime Achievement Award given by the Hispanic Professional Women's Association, the Dr. Martin Luther King Drum Major Award for Human Rights, the FBI Director's Community Leadership Award, and many others. And I know somebody's going to say, you left an important one out. You're right. There's no way I could squeeze in all the colors of her palette into one short, brief introduction. But if you take a brush and you dip them into the hues and start to paint the canvas, you'll start to see a portrait of Matilda form. Now, her efforts involving women's rights, housing, education, immigrants, Hispanic affairs are legendary. And a few years ago, speaking on behalf of one of these groups, I heard her angrily proclaim, they don't know their rights, but I know their rights. I know their rights. And someone once said, if you get mad, you should stomp your foot. Maybe you'll kick the world in the right direction. Well, Mati, your foot must be sore, because you've been kicking the world in the right direction for many years. And I'm so proud of you. Of all the things she's done, ask her what stands out in her mind. and she told me that she's particularly proud of the 43 years of the Social Security Administration. And then she added, and I loved every minute of it. What a wonderful characteristic to love to serve others. Martha, you've inspired me my whole life. You taught me that there are no excuses. Everyone, even a small Hispanic woman from very humble beginnings can make a difference if they're determined, passionate, and courageous. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to get back to that story about the girl in the tree. You see, it didn't end where I left off. The way my mother told it, while this girl was in the tree, a neighbor saw her and disapproved. So the neighbor walked out to the tree, stood underneath it, pointed to the young girl, and berated her, and said, you should come down from that tree. Climbing trees, reading books, that's for boys. Well, the young girl refused to come down. My mother told me that the neighbor took a garden hose and sprayed the young girl. In a way, she wanted to discourage her, but it didn't work. It just served to make that young girl more determined, more passionate, and more courageous. And she's been metaphorically climbing trees ever since. Ladies and gentlemen, have you finished painting the picture yet? The story that my mother told me is true. She was talking about her sister. That determined, passionate, courageous young girl demonstrating an early thirst for women's rights is none other than my godmother and the newest inductee into the Hillsborough County Women's Hall of Fame, Matilda Martinez Garcia.
That was beautiful. Matilda, thank you for that lifelong service in the thick file, and congratulations. Our third inductee was Tampa's first female assistant city attorney and municipal court judge. She paved the way for a generation of women in the legal profession, and the city of Tampa created a memorial award in her honor. Please welcome the City of Tampa's Administrator of Public Works and Utility Services, Brad Baird, to share his memories of the late Josephine Howard Stafford. Joe's daughter, Julie Stafford, will accept the honor on behalf of her mother.
Thank you. Josephine Howard Stafford was truly a pioneer for women. The word pioneer can be overused or be an exaggeration, but not for her. I want to quickly touch on a few of her pioneering feats. Mine will take only about an hour, as opposed to two. No, just a few of the her pioneering feats. For starters, she went to school at University of North Carolina in Greensboro in the late 1940s and early 1950s to get a law degree. Can you imagine, you know, during that time? I can relate to a very small degree on how big this is because I grew up in Greensboro 20 years later, nearby. And even by then, it certainly was not the most progressive place to live. President of the Florida Association for Women Attorneys, appointed by the governor. First woman judge in Hillsborough County. First executive director of what is now Bay Area Legal Services. First woman director of Tampa Hillsborough County Bar Association. First woman attorney for the city of Tampa. I could go on and on about the legal and nonprofit committees, and there were numerous. Truly an amazing life. But with all of those accomplishments, all those pioneering feats, all of that trailblazing, she was simply Miss Stafford to all of us in the city. She was our attorney, she was our friend, she was on our side. Most of all, she was a teacher. And if I didn't talk about this part of it, I would be remiss and have a lot of mad people over in the table, city table over here. We all looked to her because she was offered solutions, not reasons why we couldn't do things. She found ways to get things done. Back in those days, if we needed a legal opinion, we picked up the phone and asked Miss Stafford. Within a few minutes, she gave us one. It was that simple. Things sure have changed in 18 years. Right, Mayor? So back to the teacher part. She taught English in Germany, no less. But only those that worked with her every day knew that she continued to teach English for 24 years at the city of Tampa. Oh, yeah. She was a very good writer, including poetry. It was one of her passions. But she would call contract specialists, project managers, directors, mayors into her office, and it had to be face-to-face, you understand. Honey, you should use a semicolon here, not a comma. Semicolons are underused. Honey, she liked that word. Make sure the sideways attachments are facing to the right. You know, otherwise, the cover sheets, they bang into you when you try to look at them. Honey, how many times do I have to tell you to begin your sentences with however? But Ms. Stafford, to not begin your sentences with however, I'm sorry. But Ms. Stafford, that's just style or preference. That's not a grammar error. Honey, it's proper to put however in the middle of the sentence. But she would get out her red pen and proceed to mark it up right in front of you. X's in the margins, little squigglies on what should and shouldn't be there. And I must confess, to this day, I do the very same thing with my employees. And so do a lot of other students that are in the city of Tampa. She loved the English language and seemed to be its protector. She was a very patient person, however, with one exception, when somebody butchered the English language. She was my mentor and a mentor to many others, but she will always be my favorite teacher. I miss her. I want to close by mentioning her favorite subject, her daughter, Julie. She was so proud of Julie. Nearly a week went by when she didn't talk about how smart Julie was. By the way, she would kill me if she knew I ended a sentence with a verb, you know. But I couldn't resist that one. She did take some credit for Julie's intelligence, though, saying Julie grew up in the courtroom. You know, when and here's a quote. When she was a little girl, I would take her to court, and she absorbed everything. That's why she's so smart. Yes, Miss Stafford. When are we going to get back to the contract? Now, you don't know this, but I'm really Julie's sister. That was not a coming out. I'm really Julie's brother. Julie's, man, that was bad. Julie says I'm the son she never, her mom never had. So I'm truly honored that you invited me. I'm truly honored that you invited me here to say a few remarks about my mom and induct Josephine Howard Stafford. Thank you very much.
Thank you both for honoring her in that special way. Please join me in congratulating all of the 2015 inductees to the Hillsborough Commission Women's Hall of Fame. Next year's event will take place again in the spring, and requests for nominations will go out in the fall, and we encourage each of you to nominate one or more of the many women of influence in our community. Nominations are currently open for the Florida Women's Hall of Fame through July 15th. We obviously have so many deserving women here in Hillsborough County. Please consider submitting a nomination for that prestigious award as well. Nomination forms can be found at fcsw.net. Congressman Dennis Ross arranged for flags to fly over our Capitol building in Washington, D.C., and they'll be presented to today's inductees. We're truly grateful for this special gift and recognition. Many of our elected officials sent letters of congratulations also to commemorate this great honor for each of our winners. A special thank you to our sponsors. A special note, Pat Frank, Clerk of the Court, and Stacy Frank, for their generous sponsorship and the Bank of Tampa Women Connected. Please join me in thanking all of our sponsors for their generosity for today. It's been mentioned that the sponsorships of the Women's Hall of Fame extends beyond the room today and truly does help us with the work on issues affecting women in our county. So thank you for that. The Commission on the Status of Women also wishes to recognize the Tampa Convention Center for hosting our event, Liz Dunham for writing the inductee bios for the past 4 years, Carmen's Florist, Four Corners Framing, which I'll mention as you leave, on your left-hand side out at the front is the permanent display of the plaques commemorating the Hall of Fame, and also the League of Women Voters of Hillsborough County for all of your support with registration and beyond all that you do for the commission. Please give them all a round of applause. Those that have been here before will remember that each year I've given special recognition to one of our Commission on the Status of Women members, and I want to extend that well-deserved credit again this year. I'm deeply grateful and most of the time in complete awe of Linda DeQuilla and her tireless energy and passion for making sure all the events details are perfect. Linda, your friendship and support mean the world to me. Thank you. We offer a very special thank you to our Hillsborough County government colleagues who worked tirelessly as well to help make this event a success. Brandon Wagner, would y'all stand as I'm, Brandon's in the back, and Renee Warmack, Robert Salmon, Liana Lopez, Jennifer Hall, Adrian Frucci, Terry McElroy, Francesco Alessi, Kevin Hogue, Michael LeBou, Ryan Morrison, Scott Hunt, Beth Smedley, and Ruslana Panoff. Would y'all all give a wave? Thank you very much. Our guys from HTV. Now, we have a tradition. Under someone's saucer, you'll have a dot. And the lovely flower arrangement is yours to take home if you have that special dot. We ask you to please leave your name badges on the table so we might use them again next year. And again, thank you for coming. Have a very happy Mother's Day. Thank you.